Go.
Hold on.
Hold on.
Remember, you're going to say my name and tell and the name of the book? That's the first thing you're going to do.
And then what do I do after that?
Then start telling all the rest of the stuff.
I say, author, Patricia McKissick.
No, sentences.
Hold the book up.
My name is Tafari, and the book that I read for my summer project.
Hold it on the side so I can zoom in.
Poets. The setting of my book takes place in Harlem. Harlem is located in New York.
There, I see.
Okay.
So. All right, come on.
I was mad at the word, so doesn't that count?
Yeah.
Hello, my name is Tafari, and this is my project, A Song for Harlem. First, we have the title, A Song for Harlem. Author,
Confidence Song.
And slow down.
Hello, my name is Tafari, and this is the book, A Song for Harlem.
Join us as we explore the educational process of a young African-American male transitioning from elementary to middle school in Jackson, Mississippi. The nation's
Start with in Harlem.
In Harlem, New York.
The setting.
Put the book down.
Setting in Harlem, New York, during the Harlem Renaissance. Conflict. Alice, the rude girl in the story, bothers everyone, including Lily Bell and her friends.
What?
Nothing in the summary.
You know what the book is about. Tell what the book is about. That's all it is. The summary is telling what the book is about. The book, holding the book up. Notice that it's not covering up my face.
It wasn't covering up mine.
Just listen.
Okay.
So you hold up your book. Hello everyone, my name is Tafari. And the book that I chose to read for my summer reading project is The setting of the book takes place in Harlem, New York during the Harlem Renaissance. My book was very interesting. It was about three young children.
The school district has a $3 million
teachers next school year.
The school at whose accountable investigation last November.
Teachers next school year.
Soon after the civil rights era and the passing of desegregation laws, Jackson's white population plummeted from about 60% in 1970 to just 23% in 2006. According to the U.S. Census Bureau, many of the remaining white families in Jackson sent their children to one of the several large private schools in the area. According to Jerry Nash and Andy Taggart in their book Mississippi Politics, The Struggle for Power from 1976 to 2006, just 16 years after Brown versus Board of Education, federal courts in 1970 forced Mississippi to abolish its dual system of public education and to integrate the public school system. The result was that by the end of the 1970 school year, some 50,000 white students and an additional 1,000 white teachers had fled public schools for private academies, basically doubling the number of private schools in the state. Since this change, the Jackson public school system has been suffering and leaving parents to ask the question, public or private?
In fifth grade. For fun, I play basketball, football, soccer. I love sports and music. I practice instruments such as cello and guitar. I like cello most because I've been playing it for about 6 years now. I like the bass in music, and cello really brings out the bass because It's a low string instrument.
This will be Tafari's last year at Casey Elementary, one of the few five-star schools in the city, and one of a handful of schools that provides the arts, where Tafari learns to play the cello and the guitar.
The next piece I'm going to play is by American composer Leroy Anderson. And he actually really enjoys composing for strings. This particular piece, though, one of the interesting things is that it's all pizzicato, which is plucked, it's what we call plucking. So, we hope you enjoy.
Well, Tafari first started in Jackson Public Schools when he was in first grade. He started at Casey Elementary School. We were attracted to the school because of his whole arts curriculum. And so since he started, he has had a tremendous experience. It's been a very good experience for us.
Tafari's mother has decided to strive to enroll him in a private school, preferably St. Andrews. She will spend well over $500 alone in the application process. And once, if he is accepted, tuition and fees for her current income may total well over $5,000 a year. We contacted St. Andrews to get a better idea of what the school has to offer an incoming student, and also to find out what the admissions process would be for someone interested in attending St. Andrews School. And to no surprise, the privately funded school appeared to be light years away from the Jackson Public School system, with ACT and SAT scores in the top 10% in the nation, and it's also one of the top 100 Ivy League feeder schools, including a strong support system. The sixth grade curriculum will consist of English, history, science, mathematics, performing arts, Spanish, and beginning band. Tuition for Tafari's age, grades 5 through 8, will be over $13,000 a year and up to $400 in consolidated fees.
It was a great school. They had a lot of things that I enjoy, such as gym class, and it was an art class. It was a history class. I don't have history in my school now. Private school will be my first time going to a private school, so I'm very excited, want to meet new people, new friends.
Sure.
When I grow up, I plan to be a musician, or I plan to be a doctor. Practice makes perfect, because my dad says, if you strive for goals, then you can achieve them as long as you work hard and put effort into them. My motto is, it's not the hours you put in, but it's what you put in the hours.